Defending Tour de France champion Cadel Evans will tonight hope to cut into Bradley Wiggins' lead as the riders head into the high mountains for the first time. Ian Cohen is our man on the ground. Ian, many think this is where Cadel has the wood on Wiggins.
Absolutely, Brad. Good evening to you and good morning here in France. But you're quite right, because if he can climb and climb efficiently and climb well, then maybe he can get back inside that 1 minute 53 advantage that the Brit has at the moment. Good news, though, for Australia on today's stage to here at Bellegrade. We've actually got Simon Gerrans and Matt Goss from Orica Green Edge in a 25-man breakaway. Gerrans, we know, is a former Tour de France stage winner. He can do it in the mountains, and let's hope that there might be some success for him today. They're currently 6.5 minutes ahead of the peloton. But for Wiggins and for Cadel, it's really become a two-horse race for that general classification. Cadel, though, has questioned whether Bradley Wiggins has got the stamina to go the full 3 weeks. Now, when I asked Wiggins about that, well, he replied in glowing terms about the Australian.
I don't for 1 minute underestimate Cadel and what he's capable of doing. I mean, we're in a dream scenario at the moment, almost 2 minutes on him. We saw how he won last year, so I expect to fight every inch of the way to Paris.
And Ian, disappointingly, it hasn't taken long for the Tour to have its first drug scandal.
Yeah, look, this was disappointing, but most of the people on the Tour have just been getting on with business. As you can see, this is the front page of the paper. It hasn't taken it all up. There's Remy over there. So it's just really a small item in the French papers and obviously for a lot of the TV networks as well. He's been a part of the Cofidis team, but police have been watching him for the last couple of years since he was with Astana. He was arrested on the rest day along with two other colleagues who weren't part of the team. But the drug scandal does just continue to roll along as a bit of an undercurrent there. Cofidis was a team that in 2007 was booted out of the Tour, and Bradley Wiggins was actually a part of the Cofidis team way back then. Now, as far as that goes, well, that's certainly very, very disappointing. We're here, though, in Bellegarde. Bellegarde's one of the towns that actually bid for the race, and they pay about €90,000 to have the race here. So the people of Bellegarde are certainly enjoying it. But, Brad, I'll talk to you tomorrow night. Hopefully we might have an Aussie stage winner by then.
We'll wait and see. I think you're enjoying it too. Good on you. Thanks to Ian Cohen there at the Tour de France.